Do you hate editing? Or are you maybe just a new YouTuber who would hire a professional editor if you could afford it, but your channel's just not there yet? Or maybe you're just a control freak who likes to have your hand in every single thing that you do that has to do with promoting your channel, promoting your business, promoting whatever it is that's important to you. Or maybe you're just like me and all three apply to you. Because I will admit, I'm a new YouTuber who likes to have control in everything. If that applies to you, then this video is for you because I recently completed a 30-day YouTube challenge and I figured out a whole bunch of shortcuts in that 30 days on how to film faster, how to edit faster, how to upload faster, how to do SEO faster, how to do everything faster. Hey, just jumping in real quick because as you can tell, I'm wearing a different outfit, which means today is a different day. I actually filmed that last part about a week ago, and since then I posted another video about the New Year's resolutions for this channel. And I have also been sick for a few days, so I had to take a few days off. And while I've been editing this video here, I realized that it's way longer than I wanted to post. So I'm cutting it in half. Today, I'm just going to talk to you about Gling and how Gling can save you a ridiculous amount of time when it comes to editing your video. Then in the next video, I'm going to talk to you about Descript and how you can use Descript to get your video into a place where you can either post it if you like it, because you can add all kinds of features to it, or you can just make it very basic and you can send it to an editor and then they can glam it up. Or if you don't want to use an editor either, or you don't want Descript to be the final editing software that you use, you can still use Descript to take your video over to something like Canva and CapCut and do all of the other stuff like transitions and masking. So let's go ahead and first talk about Gling and how Gling is going to basically 100x your editing process. I also want to tell you about a new feature that they've added in the last 7 days that didn't really exist when I filmed the first part of this video. So stay tuned for that because that's near the end. And let's jump back into this. I actually used Gling every single video that I've edited. Now, I want you to keep in mind, I am a flight attendant. That means that whatever system that I use not only has to be as mobile as I am, but it has to transfer super easily from my computer to my iPad to my laptop to my phone. The system that I created as a flight attendant in order to make YouTube videos was that I bought a phone, I bought travel microphones, I plug this into my camera phone, and then I record everything with that. When I get home, I plug it into my computer, I have the videos download. But if I'm on the road and I'm gone half the time, then that doesn't work out so well, especially because I don't have my computer handy. I do take my laptop with me, and I use that for my research business. I don't like to take it with me unless I'm actually working on a research project. So I needed something else. What I ended up doing was I ended up going to the Apple store and I traded in my mini iPad for a bigger iPad with the laptop. This I take with me everywhere, largely because as a flight attendant, when I get to all these hotels, trying to watch a show on a laptop in a hotel really sucks because the Wi-Fi is really spotty. The same thing goes with most tablets, but for some reason, the Apple products really buffer the internet faster, so you're less likely to have a problem if you have some kind of Apple product. Problem is, Canva and CapCut do not cross over very well. They don't transfer easily from an Apple to a laptop to a phone at all. And every time I would start on one, if I started editing on the Apple, it wouldn't transfer to my laptop. That's why I didn't end up using Canva and CapCut. Descript, on the other hand, did. This is what I used to do my 30-day YouTube challenge. These are the three videos that I've made up to this point. As you can see, I numbered it 1, 2, 3. I'm just going to highlight all of these because they're like that. If I drag and drop them, they just fall into order. 1, 2, 3. And you can see right here in the corner, it's saying that these three videos equal 7 minutes and 18 seconds. Now I'm going to go ahead and hit continue. And here is where you need to pay attention. I haven't cut the silence. I haven't cut the bad takes. I haven't removed the fillers. I don't have it add smart captions because I'm going to take this over to Descript and I'm going to do captions over in Descript. I might hit the speech enhancement just because I want to hear it clean up my audio. I do not press jump cut zoom. And the reason I don't press jump cut zoom is because I'm going to be editing this in Descript. If you do it here, you're going to end up getting closer and farther away from the camera and you'll have no control over it and you can't fix that when you take it over to Descript. So I leave that off. Gling always tries to put a like and subscribe button inside of your video if it sees the word like or subscribe, which would be fantastic. It would be totally awesome because it's automatic. But the problem is they put a little Gling brand on it at the end. I did miss that before and I did accidentally render it into the video. By then, once you've taken it over to Descript, you can't really get rid of it. All you can do is put something over it to hide it. This is going to take a minute or two for it to do it. Luckily, since it's only a 7-minute video versus the usual 45 minutes that I throw into there, it shouldn't take too long. Now we're in Gling, and what I wanted to show you was how easy it is to use Gling. Look at this. Over here, it made 142 cuts. And it cut that 7 minutes and 12 seconds down to 5 minutes and 43 seconds. Now, that may not seem like a lot to you, but when I throw a 45-minute video into here, it generally makes about 700 or 800 cuts, and it'll cut it down to about 20 to 30 minutes a lot of times. Also, what I will do a lot of times is I will go ahead and I will change the pace. What I try to do is I try to put a little bit of extra buffer between the start and end of each one. The reason you want to do this is because what's going to end up happening is if you don't have at least a little extra, then sometimes it'll cut the words because it's looking for a half a second pause to cut. And if those two words are exactly half a second apart, it'll cut one of the words in half. If you were to say the word sentences with an S, it might say sentence and you don't get the S or the sizz at the end, which is super frustrating. So I've learned to put in 0.15. I hit apply and it redoes the cuts. And now I'm up to 6 minutes. I still have 142 cuts, but I've got 6 minutes of video now. So I just lost 20 seconds, which is okay. One of the things I really love about Gling is every time you see these little hanging sentences here, the reason that it's actually separating these out like this is because there's usually a pause that's been cut right after it. You can see it right here. And then before the sentence, there's usually a pause that cuts it as well. So every time you paused too long, then it puts that sentence as a hanging sentence so that you know you paused right before that part, you know you paused right after that part, there might be a jump. You'll definitely want to listen to that. But if it does a whole paragraph like this right here, then that means you didn't really pause at all. That means you can actually see where all of your pauses are. Now, again, one of the things that I love about Gling is see how it deleted this whole paragraph? If I want that whole paragraph back in, I just click little scissors and it's back. So you can delete and undelete a sentence by clicking the scissors. Let me scroll down here. Look at here. It cut out between the movements. What you can do is you can highlight whatever it's deleted, hit backspace, and then it'll put it back in. Or you highlight something new and you hit backspace and it deletes it back out. You can highlight things that are cut and you can click the scissors. You can do whatever you want from that. Now, what I would generally recommend is you can just go ahead and listen to everything again and make sure that everything that got cut is what you wanted to get cut. But you can also just jump straight down to things that got cut and listen to see if you want that back in. And since it does do a basic transcript for you, then you can see, okay, that got cut out because I repeated myself, or that cut out because I was saying this too much. I'm going to put this back in real quick and we're going to see how this sounds. Day YouTube challenge. And I figured out a whole bunch of shortcuts in that 30 days on how to film faster, how to edit faster, how to upload faster. Now, here's where I started the next section. This is why I always say the name of the section before I film in this video. In this video right now, see how I said it twice? So this one automatically got cut. If I leave that in, then I could maybe put a transition over it. But I'm going to go ahead and leave that out because I don't actually want that to be its own section. And I would continue on. I would see if there's anything else I want to cut. This is the easiest way to cut it because when you go into Descript, yes, you can highlight stuff and you can delete those as well. But it's a pain to highlight sometimes. And this, you can delete a whole paragraph with just a click of a sentence. That's why I like this. I try to cut as much as I can from Gling first before I go over. Now let's look at the new stuff that they've added in roughly the last week. So check it out. If you come into Gling and you hit enhance, you see this thing here that says B-roll? If you click that and then you wait like a minute or two, what it's going to do is it's actually going to find images similar to what it thinks you're talking about, and it's going to put it straight into the video. See, you can see this purple line that just popped up here? This is actually where the video is. And see, they just put in this thing. They think it's the New Year's. They think it's 2024. So that's what they put in. Obviously, that one doesn't apply. But as you go through, you can see that there's different videos that might apply to what you're talking about. Some of them are very short because they go over parts that you've cut out. If you don't want it, all you have to do is click on it and you hit delete. Let's see what this one is. Other side of my life is I've been a flight attendant for 7.5 going off 8 years. Now, obviously, that's not a flight attendant part, but you can drag this and you can move it around to something that you like better. And you can see it's highlighting here. If you don't want it, you just click on it and you delete it. So that's another nice new feature that Gling has added, is that you can now add AI B-roll to your video. It looks like you can do, see, this one is another image. It says for 20 years, the other side has been a flight attendant. Like right here, you can actually search videos, flight attendant, and you can actually change it out. So that's a nice new feature for Gling that I just wanted to make sure to add. So then that way you can actually think about, do you want to have Gling automatically throw some videos in for you? Just make sure that you watch them all just in case it doesn't actually apply to whatever it is you're saying. And now let's go ahead and get back to the rest of my previous video. This all looks good to me. I'm just going to go ahead and change the title name. I always put Gling before this, because I want to make sure that all of the videos in the same folder, that I don't confuse them when I go to upload to YouTube. So I put Gling first, and then I say what this is, how to edit faster. And I'm going to hit export as a video. Let me pull this over here so you can see. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and find that file. So I'm going to render it in here, and you can see there's three other video files. These were the three original video files. If there's a number in front of it, I know this was the original raw footage. If I have Gling in front of it, then I know this is the Gling edit. I'm going to hit save. Gling now tends to be about 1 minute for every video that you edit. So if you did a 15-minute video, you can just walk away for 15 minutes and come back. Now, here's the trick that I really like. I usually end up with about 9 files that I'll put together to make my videos. If I drop them all into Descript right away by coming over Underlord, I can have it remove retakes. I can have it shorten word gaps. And I can have it remove filler words, which is the same thing Gling does, but it's so much easier to edit in Gling, in my opinion, which is why I continue to do it. But the key reason that I do it is because now over here, I have one file. And with that one file, I can now go ahead and I can start editing this. So I'm going to click on my video here, and I'm going to put a filter in. That way, my camera, which tends to film a bit darker, will get lighter. So I'll hit effects, and I'll come over here, add plus to the effects. I will go to color adjustments, and I'll click on effect settings. And now I put in whatever my percentages are. Usually for my camera, it's a 10, 10, like 20 to brighten the background. And then I'll do a 5% saturation to give it just a little bit of pinkness. Once I'm happy with the way it looks, then I will basically just stop editing it. So that's the first thing I do. And now I've edited everything just one time. Okay, guys, in case you didn't catch it already, there's so many things I love about Gling. One of that being that you could take 10, 20, 30 files and render it into one video. And then taking that one video over to Canva, CapCut, Descript, Final Cut Pro, Premiere, wherever, you can actually then alter the coloring by using filters and make your video look better. So even if your camera really sucks, like mine pretty much sucks, then you can just automatically make it better with your editing software. And if you had 9 or 10 or 12 or 30 videos, you have to do that for each video individually. Rendering all of that into one video first is going to save you a lot of time. The other thing is that Gling is going to make hundreds and even thousands of cuts for you in less than 5 minutes. If you were to pay an editor to do that, it would cost you a fortune. Think about how they would have to look for each one individually and cut it themselves. So in my opinion, $10 a month to render 10 hours of video is really worth it. If your videos are 20 minutes a piece when they're rendered, then that means that you can roughly get 30 videos edited by Gling for just $10 a month. How much would you pay an editor to do that? That's so much money, am I right? But even if you only did the free version, which is 1 hour of rendered video per month, if your videos are 5 minutes, then you can do 12. If they're 10 minutes, you can do 6. You know what I mean? For the free version. So it's up to you to decide. I did sign up to be an affiliate with them after making this video. They did approve my application, so I will put a link in the bottom so that if there was a discount or anything like that, that you would get it. The other thing that I love about Gling, besides the hundreds of edits, the single file, the sound enhancement, which is very good. It cleans it up so well. So that's going to save you money too. You won't have to pay for any kind of audio software to do that for you. But the new B-roll feature is fantastic. So check that out. Play with that, because how much time would that save you to be able to search for free images in your B-roll within Gling versus trying to manually do that in another software? And tomorrow I am going to go ahead and talk about Descript. So if you want to see that, make sure you subscribe and hit the notification bell. If you liked the video, please let me know by hitting the like button or asking me questions in the comments. I try to answer every question that people ask me. And also, question of the day, what's the editing software that you use? Put that in the comments. I would love to know. In the meantime, the next video I'm going to do, I'm going to finish up the Descript part, which is longer than this video. I'm also working on part one of my New Year's resolution, which is to basically help you with your small business gain extra streams of passive income so that your business can survive through the hard times. So again, if you want that kind of information, make sure you hit the subscribe button. In the meantime, see you in the next video. Ciao!